Hi, I'm Julieanne Kost. In the next few minutes, we're going to get familiar with Lightroom Classic's new masking features. The new masking icon provides access to all of the tools with a single click. There are two new tools, Select Subject and Select Sky, both of which make selections using artificial intelligence and machine learning. Next, we have all of the previous local adjustment tools, the brush, linear gradient, and radial gradient, and the color, luminance, and depth range map controls have been elevated to their own tools, making them even more powerful than before. Selecting a tool displays the mask panel, which can be repositioned, collapsed into list view, and even docked into the panel track. We can use the brush settings to change the brush size, the feather or the hardness of the brush edge, and the flow. I'll click once, then hold the Shift key and continue clicking around the window. Lightroom Classic displays the default red mask overlay. If I paint in the wrong area, I can switch to the eraser tool and then paint in order to remove the mask. As soon as I make an adjustment, Lightroom Classic automatically hides the mask overlay. To apply the same adjustment, but to a lesser degree, I'll decrease the flow, then increase the brush size and paint inside of the room. Positioning the cursor over the mask thumbnail displays the mask overlay, or we can tap the O key to toggle the Show Overlay option. Several different overlay options can be selected from the panel. To view the mask similar to a layer mask in Photoshop, choose white on black. For now, I'll reset that. We can also double-click to rename a mask, making it easier to find if we want to re-edit it later. It's easy to duplicate a mask, and then use the invert option to affect the rest of the image. I'll reset the sliders by double-clicking the effects and then decrease the saturation. You can toggle the visibility of a mask to temporarily hide it, or click the More icon to delete the mask with its edits altogether. I'll click the plus icon to add another mask, this time selecting the linear gradient. You'll notice that all of the sliders have been reset thanks to the new Reset Slider Automatically option. I'll click and drag up from the bottom of the image, then I'll increase dehaze to darken the bottom of the image as well as add saturation to the windowsill. Next, I'll add a radial gradient and increase the exposure and increase dehaze. However, the window divider is also being affected. Fortunately, you can combine as many tools as are needed to create a mask. I'll choose Subtract, select the brush, and then paint to hide the effects of the radial gradient. Each component of the mask can be edited independently. You can select the component in the masks panel, or click on the corresponding pin in the image area. Each component can be repositioned and, in the case of the radial gradient, resized independently of one another. As always in Lightroom Classic, all of the adjustments are non-destructive. At any time, you can return to any of the masks and refine their settings. To toggle the visibility of all of the masks, use the switch in the upper left of the Masks panel. In this next image, I'll choose Select Subject. Lightroom Classic quickly selects the Joshua tree, and I'll start by increasing the shadows. Then I'll choose Select Sky, and Lightroom Classic will automatically select the sky. I'll choose Add, and just paint in this little area before making some edits. I'll decrease the highlights, increase the whites, and then add some clarity. Now the left side of the image needs to be darkened down a bit, so I'll add a linear gradient and decrease the exposure. But I don't want the gradient to darken the shadow areas of the mountains, so I'll choose Subtract. I'll enable Auto Mask so that Lightroom will automatically detect the edges of the mountain, and then paint to subtract from the mask in that area. And finally, I'll choose color range, then use the eyedropper to sample the color in the flowers. I'll use the refine slider to adjust which color range is affected, increase the exposure, and decrease the saturation. Then to hide the effects in the foreground, I'll choose subtract, select the brush, and quickly paint to hide the mask. To quickly toggle the visibility of all of our changes, I'll use the switch, before, and after. So there you go, a quick overview of the new masking tools in Lightroom Classic.